Look what I got. It's finally here, my autobiography. This is the first printed copy. That's why it says not for resale, but that won't be there when you buy it. So it's for sale now. It's called A Movie Making Nerd. It takes you through my entire history from growing up making zero budget films before YouTube, before the internet, before digital video, all the way to creating web series like The Angry Video Game Nerd. If you've seen Cinemassacre 200 and The Dragon in My Dreams, those are two videos that many fans have told me they were inspired by, and I was really moved by that. So if you like those, this is sort of like an expanded literary version. It goes much more in depth, far more in depth than anything I've ever put out there before. There's a lot more personal stuff in here, and it goes outside filmmaking to talk about life in general. I talk about the good times, the triumphs, and successes, but I also talk about the bad times. I talk about my past, dealing with depression, anxiety, self-esteem issues, troubles in school, all things that I've overcome and moved on from. It's like a coming-of-age story about growing up, learning from mistakes, and it also goes into adulthood and talks about finding employment and raising children, with the main theme of how I turned my hobby into a career. I made sure to include a lot of funny stories too, even embarrassing ones, anything I remembered to give you some laughs along the way. I made sure to put it all down. I just wanted to share all the experiences from my life that impacted me. It's important to me, and I know it'll be important to someone else. And the reason I know is because I've read a lot of autobiographies that inspired me. It's my favorite type of literature. There's nothing like getting the full story from an artist you enjoy, whether it's an actor, director, or musician. As an example, when I was around 15, I read Rebel Without a Crew by Robert Rodriguez. Before that, I never had any confidence to make movies. But then I read about this 23-year-old guy who raised some money for an incredibly low-budget film, El Mariachi. He didn't let anything hold him back. He just went out there and did it, and that motivated me. And then, sometime later, I read this book by Lloyd Kaufman, All I Need to Know About Filmmaking I Learned from the Toxic Avenger. This one also inspired me, but it was also very funny, even self-deprecating at times. So with these kind of books, they can be happy, sad, funny, maybe gives a little advice here and there. The best are when they share all the personal stuff, and maybe you read something in there and triggers a memory of your own, something relatable, makes you feel not so alone, gives you perspective, gives you motivation to pursue your own thing. I love these kind of books, love them, so I knew I had to pass down my own story for anyone else who might find value in it. In fact, I started writing this 20 years ago. The first drafts were on floppy disks. I wrote this stuff down while it was still fresh in my mind, and in all the years since, I've had many more stories to add, so this was always a growing work in progress. But now, it's finally out. I poured my heart and soul into this. It's not just any story, it's my whole life story. It's my example, and I'm giving it to you. I hope it serves as some kind of inspiration. You can get it on Amazon. There's a physical version and a Kindle version. Also, there's an audio version read by me, so take your pick.